everybody. This is Jason from Steinbach, Manitoba. We're at I-90 at the moment, and you are watching Trucker Josh Live. Enjoy!
Everybody, there's water falling from the sky. It's falling all over the place.
We have to deliver some of this stuff today. We're getting two deliveries done. There's six deliveries on here. Our first delivery here is Oxbow, Saskatchewan. That's that unit there. That's this here. And when we get there, it's just down the road. We're in Carnduff, Saskatchewan. Hopefully when we get there, this rain will have decided that it has rained enough because it was raining all night already. It would be very nice if it would leave me alone.
Right.
I'm practicing my Scottish. Hey, right. Or is this right? Is it all right or is it just right? Right. I'll have to ask my friend, Waddy. Hopefully one day we can go and visit there yet. There's so many places we want to go and visit. I'd love to do a Europe tour. And United Kingdom and Ireland. We'll see. Life is only so long. There's only so many things you can do. Turn the lights on, release the brakes. We are good to go. I'm just gonna double check that what I saw with my fifth wheel is true, that we are still attached. And give her a little... Yep, that trailer is not going anywhere, except with me. Okay, we gotta go deliver some stuff. Drove till 2 in the morning, Central Time, last night. In true Trucker Josh fashion. It seems that that's always my schedule on the road. I'm actually, I like that schedule. I don't know why. Is this a driveway or is this a road? I think that's a driveway to that business. Oh, whatever, I stopped anyway. The rain is slowing down at least. Hopefully it continues to slow down. I think I've had enough rain. But what do I know, right? So that over there is Carnduff, Saskatchewan. Never heard of it before? Me neither. Carnduff. Not corn, Carn. C-A-R-N-D-U-F-F. I think that's how you spell it. Carnduff. Is Carnduff a funny name? yes, I am here all day. I'm gonna wait for that car because I'm way too nice again. You see, I'm the guy that actually doesn't want to cut people off. There's so many people out there who would have just gone, wouldn't care. I get cut off every day. I don't want to be that guy who cuts people off. Not on purpose, anyway. I mean, sometimes it's an accident. All right, here we go. Come with me, my farm equipment. My farm boys. Gotta deliver these buckets. So Oxbow, Saskatchewan here is taking one bucket and one crate. And then we run up to another town, Redvers, I think? Is that the one? I don't know, we have a second drop today that we're gonna get done. It's about an hour and a half away, a little further south here, I think. And then we have 5.5 or 6 hours to our next delivery. And that one we're gonna do tomorrow. We have 4 stops we're gonna do tomorrow. We're gonna get them all done. So today is Tuesday. We'll get them all done Wednesday. And hopefully we can get reloaded Thursday. That'd be nice. Ooh, Cadillac, very fancy. We got some fancy farmers. Fancy farmers. Very nice. Good to see the farmers doing well. It's carned off a fancy car. I messed that up. Cut that out, Josh. Carned off a fancy car. Carned off a fancy car. Carned off a fancy car that just came through Carned off. I'll shut up now. All right. Very nice people here. They took one loader and one crate. Now we go to Redbird, Saskatchewan, which is a little under an hour away. They're also just taking one loader and one crate. Can I get around the back this way? Kind of soft back here. Hope I don't get stuck. Though I'm not really worried about it if I would. I mean, I think they got the equipment to get me out. Can I get out this way? They told me I could go all the way around, I'm pretty sure. Excuse me. Yeah, there's branches on the ground here. There's branches all over the place. Oh, yeah, over here too. Tornado warnings here yesterday, right? My phone went nuts and sent me the alarm. Oh, some trees that broke down over there. That reminds me, we really need to get our, oh, I can't get out this way. Okay, well, I can't go that way. Okay, they meant go all the way around over there. Okay, let's get our tires a little muddy. Why not? That's okay. Look at all these branches all over the place here. Yikes. That does remind me, though, we need to call the arborist to get those trees taken down in our backyard before that happens and takes out all those power lines. I don't think it will happen, but I don't want to risk it. It makes me uncomfortable. Eek, yeah, that tree must have come down last night. It was windy here. I don't know if a tornado touched down anywhere, but I was definitely getting the warnings on my phone. Yikes. Oh! Well, they got this blocked off here too. Okay. I have another option, don't worry. I can see my trailer back there through the window. Just gonna back down the driveway I just came from. Okay, we're gonna go that way. And we shall go this way. Look at this, yikes. There's carnage out here. Wow, that's a huge tree. It wasn't like super, super windy to the point where I was like nervous that my truck would get blown off the road, but it was definitely to the point where I was concerned. Especially once my phone started to tell me, there's a tornado warning in your area. Seriously? I don't got time for no tornado. I got stuff to do. Okay, now we can go back out the way we came. All right, we made that way harder on ourselves than we had to. My tires are all muddy now. Ah, well, it is what it is. We'll wash it off and it'll be clean again. Never been to this town. It's actually a nice place. We're gonna go right through town here again. I'm gonna show you it a little bit. Saskatchewan. Seems like a mixture between agriculture and oil. A lot of oil rigs out here. Oh, someone's getting a new roof. Nice. Oh, it's the public works building, I see. The old elevator. That's how this town was born and sustained in the beginning, I'm sure. Everything was brought in by rail. All the farmers would bring their feed and their grains and stuff to here, and then we get loaded on the trains and head out to wherever it goes. Now we got truckers like me. It's a little faster. A little more personalized. I'll take your load directly to the customer. No need to go through the train where it takes like 3 to 6 weeks. No, I'll get it there tomorrow. That was downtown, I guess. Gas prices are $1.90 a liter here, which is a little over $6 a gallon, US gallon, or about $5.50 USD per US gallon. About $5.50 American a gallon. With no relief in sight. We have people in charge that are intent on kneecapping their own people. Why help us thrive when you can shove our face into the dirt just because you can, you know? Stopped here in Balgoni, grabbed some fuel and a shower. Purchased 527 liters of fuel, 138 gallons US. Cost me $1,048 Canadian. Who knows what that is in US? $900? $800? I guess I don't need these anymore. Sun's going down. I'm gonna try to get to David's in Saskatchewan and spend the night there. Only averaged 5.57 miles per gallon on that last tank. We were fighting the wind pretty hard last night going through that storm. It is what it is. Let's go.
Got this left on us now. It's the next morning again. We're gonna continue this trip. a little bit.
This is Chamberlain, Saskatchewan. Those of you who've been following me for many, many years know that right over there in front of that truck, in the dead of winter, several years ago, is where I broke down. That was the day I learned about how diesel fuel can gel in the cold weather. Tough lesson to learn, but I got pretty lucky. Getting kind of bright out here now, though. Let's, there we go. There we go. Better. Yeah, this was the town. I was actually just north of here, between here and Davidson. It was closer to Chamberlain, so I turned around and I started coming back here when I noticed the truck was sputtering. I didn't know what was going on. I learned that day that you never go to sleep in the wintertime with empty tanks of fuel. Always go to sleep with full tanks. Always. Especially if you have American fuel in the tanks. The fuel in the US is mixed a little bit differently than the fuel here in Canada in the wintertime. In the wintertime, our fuel is designed for extreme cold weather, whereas theirs, even in the northern states, is designed sort of for really cold weather. It's pretty good, but once you get up here, it was minus 65 that day, Celsius. If you're wondering what that is in Fahrenheit, what is minus 65 Celsius in Fahrenheit?
Minus 65 degrees Celsius is equal to minus 85 degrees Fahrenheit.
That's how cold it was. It was cold. Fuel froze up, and I went to bed the night before in Montana, which is south of here, and I slept with a quarter tank of fuel. I'm like, oh, I'll fuel in the morning, whatever, no big deal, no big deal. Well, the whole tank, I guess the condensation on the tank turns to water. That goes into the fuel, mixes with the fuel. It's a bad thing, and it gels up. The fuel turns into gel, which plugs up your fuel filters and shuts off your truck. Your truck won't run. So now it's minus 65 and my truck won't run. And so I managed to limp it back here, barely, and go and beg the hotel over there to let me have a room with my dog Diesel, because they weren't a pet-friendly hotel, and they were kind of, that I had a dog. But I'm like, it's minus 65. What, do you want us to die out here? Like, please let us have a room. So they let me have a room with my dog. Very nice. And actually, they're very nice people. They just had a no pet policy. And, you know, once you explained to them the situation, of course they let us stay there right away, which is really nice of them. The next day we had a tow truck come here, pick me up from here, pick the truck up from here and tow it into Regina, south of here, where they pretty much just put it in a shop overnight, changed the fuel filters, and good to go. I learned how easy it is to prevent fuel gelling and how easy it is to fix it. It's just really scary when you don't know what's going on and when you're not aware of the fact that fuel can gel. That's not something that they'll necessarily teach you in trucking school. That's not something that's, maybe they will, maybe they do already. I was never taught that. I mean, maybe they did, maybe they mentioned, maybe people have mentioned it to me before, but it's never really sunk in. What do you mean fuel gelling? I'll be fine. Nothing bad ever happens to me. So here we are in 2022. Bad things happen to me. It does. Yeah, I'm not immune to those bad things. I'm not invincible. So you gotta be prepared, you gotta be ready, and you gotta know what to do.
Okay, we need to get moving. It's rock and roll. Take my trailer with me, that's good. Nice shiny Kenworth. Wow, you see that? That's a nice one too. Why am I so close to my steering wheel? Okay, here we go. Oh, this is two bikes. One there and one here. I always get asked if I would ever pull them. Yeah, of course. I'd pull them if I had the chance. I wouldn't want to do it all the time, I don't think. Like, I wouldn't want that to be my full-time gig, but of course I'd love to add that to my resume and pull a set of 53-foot pikes. I mean, I think it'd be fun. Make a great video. Yeah.
Chamberlain is settled right along a beautiful valley over there. Runs all the way through Saskatchewan. Off we go, another day begins. I guess it's the same day for you guys. Sometimes I like to split the days up like this, and you get more content in one if not a lot happened in, like, not a lot happened yesterday. Take you along for a little bit more of a ride today. This is Outlook. Outlook Saskatchewan, not Microsoft Outlook. Saskatchewan Outlook. Oh, here's the town. Okay. Welcome to Outlook, everybody, in Saskatchewan. Big hot spot for tourist destinations if you're looking for one. They got a gas station. Gas prices are slightly lower than Manitoba. That's exciting. Looks like they've got a hardware convenience store all in one. They got a bargain shop. What a bargain. Come on down to Outlook, Saskatchewan. They have people. At least a couple of them. They got a liquor store. What else? What else do you need on your vacation? Why is there a bag in my lane? I don't want to drive over that. I don't know what's in it. I'm gonna go around that one. Yeah. They got a printer store. Oh, they got another liquor store. In case you're on this side of town. They got one on this side of town too. Sort of like Tim Horton. There's one on every corner within walking distance. I haven't seen a Timmy's yet though. Did we pass it already? They've got to have a Timmy's. If they don't have a Timmy's, forget everything I just said. Oh yeah, they got a little war memorial over there. That's good. Good. Are you stopping too? I stop first, I gotta go. That's the rules, I don't make them, I just follow them. Nice little town though, eh? Not bad. This is a prairie town for you. Feels like home. They even got dead trees, just like us. Reminds me, again, I have to call the arborist, get them to cut that dead tree down in our backyard. That one I can't do myself. There's way too many buildings around us and power lines. I'm gonna have to get a professional in there who has insurance. So that if they mess something up, they can deal with it. If I mess something up, my insurance company's be like, what were you doing cutting down a tree in town? So, I just don't wanna answer those questions. I thought I could do it myself. Clearly I can't. Another gas station on this side of town in case you run out of gas on this side of town. There you go, a motel for you to stay at. Look at this, I'm a tour guide now. Very nice, a car wash in case you get a dirty car. More people, so you can talk to people. Absolutely, look at this, even a subway. Every little town has a subway. Wealth management, for all you rich folks, there's a wealth management store over there. Or whatever that is. Here we are. Rosetown, Saskatchewan. My sister's name is Rose. She has her own town. Look at this.
Your destination is on the right.
Thank you. Thank you. I noticed. Where would they like me to park? I'm guessing they're probably gonna want me around back, but for now, I think I'm gonna park up here and walk inside there. And they can let me know where they want me. People can get around me from here. I'll let the load gods know I have arrived, composed, arrived at stop off number 3 in Rosetown. Rosetown. Saskatchewan. Oh, I spelled Rosetown wrong. Oops. Roseton. Rosetown. There you go. Send that away. Yes, I'm sure I'd like to send that message. Absolutely. That's why I wrote it. We will put this on duty status to on duty. Unloading cargo. Where to go here? Unloading cargo so that it is on record that I am here on duty, not driving, trying to get unloaded. Wonderful, wonderful. Maybe they'll unload me right here, then I don't have to go through that mud.
What am I doing here? It's...
No need to waste fuel while I go inside. Okay. Let's just make sure. I know I'm in the driveway here, but I think I left enough room for people to get around me while I figure out where they want me. Oh yeah, plenty of room. Oh yeah. I'm not gonna be here long. So this is theirs here. This cutter. That's the only thing. They're just taking this. So it shouldn't take too long. We should be out of here soon. All right, I'm just gonna maneuver myself over this way a little bit. And they're gonna come and unload me right here. Just wanna get out of the driveway here just in case if some kind of big heavy truck comes in or a big tractor that I'm not gonna be in their way.
Look at these machines though, eh?
I know I'm a highway tractor guy, but it must be fun driving those tractors too. I just love big machines. Don't those look like fun? I got to drive a big combine when I was younger. It was, my parents' cousins. I was one of our cousins. They had a bunch of farmland. We lived on their farm for a while, and I helped them with harvest. Got to drive the grain truck, got to drive, like, not by myself, but I got to, act like I was combining for a while. That's fun. Never got to drive a big tractor like this with tracks, but they did have a big four-wheel drive with, four tires on each side, so like the eight wheels. And it pulled a big air seater combination. Oh, so much fun. So much fun. I love farms. Okay, so they got their mower off of here now. Brought it in over there. And now I got this left. Swift Current, this is my next one. And I'm gonna have to do that in tomorrow's video because we got quite a bit of footage now. I think this is enough for one day. I think we'll be good. There was just a fly that landed on my GoPro. Do you guys hear that? It landed like right on the mic. Anyways. Okay. That's it for today. Me and Old Blue. Or Old Blue and I. Proper English. Old Blue and I will see you tomorrow. Take care.